with Sarah, a true lover of maths. Today we will continue with the topic real numbers, chapter 1. It is part 5. Before watching this video, please watch part 1, 2, 3 and 4. In this video, I am going to prove root 2, root 3, etc. as irrational numbers. We know if p is a prime number, then root p is an irrational number. In class 9, you have learned real numbers and irrational numbers. What are irrational numbers? Any number which cannot be written in the form p by q, or a non-terminating or non-repeating decimal gives an irrational number. And we have learned how to represent them on number line 2. Here we are going to prove root 2, root 3, root 5, etc. as irrational numbers mathematically. For proving that, we need a theorem and as well as a new method. In order to prove root 2 as irrational number, we need a theorem as well as a new method. The theorem states, if p is any prime number and a any positive integer, if p divides a square, then p divides a also. Theorem says, p any prime number and a any positive integer, if p divides a square, then p divides a also. What is the meaning of this? You know, 2 is a prime number and 6 any positive integer. In place of p, we are taking 2, and in place of a, 6. If p divides 6 square, p divides 6 square means 2 divides 36. Is 2 divides 36? Yes. 36 is completely divisible by 2. 36 is completely divisible by 2. 2 divides 36, then 2 divides 6 2. Then 2 divides 6 2. This is the meaning. If 2 divides 6 square, then 2 divides 6 2. This is a theorem we are using to prove root 2 as irrational number. Second one is the method used. What is the method used? Method used is called method of contradiction. Method of contradiction. This method is new to you. What is method of contradiction? In order to prove something as true, suppose p is true, take the opposite of p as true. Take the opposite of p as true means tilde p as true. Opposite of p can be written as tilde p. Then proceed. We arrive at a result which contradicts our assumption. We arrive at a result which contradicts our assumption. We arrive at a result which contradicts our assumption. That means our assumption is wrong, or we can conclude that P is true. P is true. Means our assumption wrong, that is p is true. So we can conclude that p as true. Once again, in order to prove p as true or root 2 as irrational, take p opposite of p, that is tilde p, as true, root 2 as a rational number. Proceed. We arrive at a result which contradicts our assumption. That means our assumption is wrong or p is true. This method of proving something is called method of contradiction. So in order to prove root 2 as an irrational number, we use this method and this theorem. No need to by heart it. Prove that root 2 is an irrational number. The method used is method of contradiction. So let us suppose root 2 as a rational number. Opposite of p as 2. Let us assume that root 2 is a rational number. then we can write it in the form p by q. Therefore, their x is p and q such that root 2 is equal to p by q. Root 2 is equal to p by q. One more important thing, where p and q are coprime numbers. What is the meaning of coprime? What is the meaning of coprime? Coprime numbers means their HCF is 1. There is no common factor between p and q. That is the meaning of coprime numbers. Two numbers are said to be coprime. P and q are said to be coprime if their HCF is 1. That means there is no common factor between p and q. Now, squaring both sides. We get root 2 square is 2 is equal to p square upon q square. 2 is equal to p square upon q square. Cross multiplying, we get p square is equal to 2q square. P square is equal to 2q square. That means p square is a multiple of 2. P square is a multiple of 2. Or we can say 2 divides p square. What can we say? 2 divides p square. 2 divides p square. Then 2 divides p also. 2 divides p also. Why? The theorem says so. If p is a prime number, a is a positive number, p divides a square, then p divides a also. 2 divides 36, then 2 divides 6, 2. So we can write 2 divides p. If 2 divides p, then we can write p as 2r. Then we can write p as 2r. What is the meaning of p divides 2? If we divide p by 2, the remainder is equal to 0. So we can write p as 2r. Okay? Now, substituting this in equation 1, we get, substituting p as 2r in equation 1, we get 2r the whole square is equal to 2q square. Cancelling 2 on both sides, we get q square is equal to 2r square. Q square is equal to 2r square. That means what? Q square is equal to 2r square means 2 divides q square. That means 2 divides q square. If 2 divides q square, then 2 divides q also. So we can write 2 divides q. That means we can write q as a multiple of 2. Q as a multiple of 2. Okay? Now look at equations 2 and 3. P is equal to 2r and q is equal to 2m. What is the meaning of that? That means P and Q have common factor 2. P and Q have common factor 2. Which contradicts the fact that P and Q are coprime numbers. We assume root 2 as a rational number. So we can write it in the form P by Q, where P and Q are coprime numbers. Now we get P is equal to 2R and Q is equal to 2M. That means P and Q have common factor 2, which contradicts the fact that P and Q are coprime numbers. So, what can we write? From 2 and 3, we can write P and Q have common factor 2. Which contradicts our assumption that P and Q are coprime numbers. That means, where is wrong? Our assumption is wrong. is an irrational number. Therefore, we can conclude that. So we can conclude that root 2 is an irrational number. Irrational number. Very easy. To prove root 2 is irrational, we need a method and a theorem. No need to by heart it. The purpose of maths is not by hearting something. To understand something. Understand the logic. Okay. So listen carefully. Let us assume root 2 as a rational number. If something is rational, then we can write it in the form p by q. If any number is a rational number, then we can write it in the form p by q. So, there exists p and q such that root 2 is equal to p by q, where p and q are coprime numbers. It is in the reduced form. It is already in the reduced form. There is nothing common between p and q. Or the HCF of P and Q is equal to 1. That is the meaning of coprime numbers. Now, squaring both sides, cross multiplying, we get P square is equal to 2Q square. That means P square is a multiple of 2, or you can write 2 divides P square. If 2 divides P square, then 2 divides P also according to the theorem. If 2 divides P, that means this, if we divide p by 2, quotient is something and remainder is equal to 0. So, we can write p as a multiple of 2. P is equal to 2y. Substitute this value in equation 1. We get q square is equal to 2r square. In place of p, write 2r. Substituting in 1, we get 2r the whole square is equal to 2q square. Cancelling 2, we get q square is equal to 2r square. That means what? Q square is a multiple of 2, or 2 divides q square. If 2 divides q square, then according to the theorem, 2 divides q 2. That means we can write q as a multiple of 2. What is the meaning? From 2 and 3, we can see that P and Q have common factor 2. P and Q have common factor 2, which contradicts the fact that HCF of P and Q is 1. Or P and Q are coprime numbers. That means what? Our assumption, root 2 is rational. Our assumption is wrong. That means we can conclude that root 2 is an irrational number. I hope root 2 is irrational is clear to you. We can use the same thing to prove root 3 as irrational. Okay? Let us start. Root 3 is an irrational number. The question is, prove that root 3 is an irrational number. Then, what is the method used? Contradiction. That means, let us assume that root 3 is a rational number. Then, there exists P and Q such that root 3 is equal to P by Q. Where P and Q are coprime numbers. Means their HCF is 1. Squaring both sides, we get root 3 square is 3. 3 is equal to P square upon Q square. That means P square is equal to 3Q square. P square is a multiple of 3. Or we can write 3 divides P square. P square is a multiple of 3. Or we can write 3 divides P square. If 3 divides P square, then 3 divides P also. Then 3 divides P also. That means we can write P as a multiple of 3. We can write P as a multiple of 3. Substituting in equation 1, we get 3r the whole square is equal to 3q square. 3r the whole square is equal to 3q square. Cancelling 3 on both sides, we get q square is equal to 3r square. Q square is equal to 3r square. That means q square is a multiple of 3, or we can write 3 divides q square. 3 divides q square. If 3 divides q square, then according to the theorem, 3 divides q also. If 3 divides q completely, then we can write q as 3m. Q as 3m. Now look at equation 2 and 3. What can you see? We can see that P is equal to 3R and Q is equal to 3M. That means P and Q have common factor 3. P and Q have common factor 3. Which contradicts the fact that P and Q are coprime numbers. There is nothing common. So, our assumption is wrong. That means we can conclude that root 3 is an irrational number. I hope now you know how to prove root 2 and root 3 as irrational numbers. Let us prove one more. Root 5. Prove that root 5 is an irrational number. Root 5 is an irrational number. Let us do it together. Okay? What is the first step? Let us assume root 5 is a rational number. Let us assume that root 5 is rational. Then there exists P and Q such that root 5 is equal to P by Q. This step is very important where P and Q are coprime numbers. Where P and Q are coprime numbers. There is nothing common between P and Q. Then squaring both sides we get 5 is equal to P square upon Q square. Or we can write P square as 5Q square. We can write P square as 5Q square on cross multiplying it. This means what? P square is a multiple of 5. Or we can write 5 divides P square. If 5 divides P square, then 5 divides P. Okay? Then we can write P as a multiple of 5, then we can write P as a multiple of 5. That means 5R, the whole square. Substituting P as 5R in equation 1, we get 5R the whole square is equal to 5Q square. But cancelling 5 on both sides, we get Q square is equal to 5R square. That means what? Q square is a multiple of 5, or we can write 5 divides Q square. If 5 divides Q square, then 5 divides Q also. Then we can write Q as a multiple of 5. Q as a multiple of 5. Now look at 2 and 3. From 2 and 3 we can see that P and Q have common factor 5. P and Q have common factor 5. Which contradicts the fact that P and Q are coprime numbers. Then what is wrong? Our assumption is wrong. So what can we conclude? We can conclude that root 5 is an irrational number. Root 5 is an irrational number. Hope you are clear with the concept of how to prove root 2, root 3, root 5, etc. as irrational numbers. Very easy. Method of contradiction as well as this theorem. With the help of this two, we can prove it. Hope all of you are enjoying my classes. Thank you for watching my video. If you have any doubt, comment below. I am here to support you. If you like my videos, like, share and subscribe it too. I will be back with more videos. Till then, bye.